Now onwards, we will enter into the real subjects and what are the different steps we will follow here in the vibration analysis. Okay. First and foremost thing is, you need to identify the elements that are there in the vibrating system. What are the elements? Elements are like a mass, a spring, and then the damping, dashpot. Okay. Well, we will study about that and how to identify whether it is a translating or a rotating. If it is a translating, what to consider. If it is rotating, what to consider. Okay, we will see those. First you need to identify what are the things that are there, and after that, identifying, you need to choose the appropriate method to form the equation of motion. So what is the meaning of this equation of motion? Finally, what you want to find out, what is your main objective from this chapter? The main objective from this chapter is to reduce the vibration produced by any system. So how will you do that? By knowing how it is vibrating. Okay, so how will you know that how the system is vibrating? By knowing some curve. Okay, for example, here this is a harmonic curve. Okay, harmonic curve, which is in terms of the either a cos or a sine. Okay, if it is going something like this, so if you know the curve, okay, if you know this curve, then I can find out the amplitude of this curve and then the time period of this curve. Okay, so the different properties of this curve can be found out, and if I know the amplitude, then I can know how much maximum distance it is moving while vibrating. Okay, so by knowing that, I can either avoid or partially remove these vibrating effects. Okay, so here to find this curve, there are different steps that are involved here to find out this final curve. So first of all, we need to find the equation of motion. Equation of motion will be in terms of differential equation. Okay, this equation of motion will come in terms of the differential equation. Okay, so first you will get the differential equation. You need to form the differential equation. From this differential equation, you can find various concepts like natural frequency. Okay, and then if there is a damping, then damped frequency. Okay, and then we will define, along the way we will define some of the concepts like coefficient of damping ratio. Okay, damping ratio and so on. We will define so many things, so you can find out there here from this differential equation. Okay, so we will spend a lot of time here. When we form the equation of motion, we will spend a lot of time. Why? Because most of the questions that are coming, 80% of the questions are coming to find out this omega n. What is the natural frequency of this particular vibrating system? Okay, so that can be found out directly from this differential equation. Okay, so forming the differential equation is very, very crucial part. After that, it is a cakewalk. Okay, so we will spend a lot of time by taking a lot of examples here. Okay, and differential equation we will form. How you form the differential equation, we will consider different types of system. Okay, in some cases it is a free system. Free system means, what is the meaning of that? Free system means here there is no external force that is acting on the system here. And sometimes we will take the natural vibration without any damping. Okay, C equal to 0. And in some cases we will take the C is not equal to 0. That means there is a damping. In that case, how to form the differential equations? Okay, we will see all these cases. And once if you find this differential equation, which is called as the equation of motion, sometimes we may directly write EOM instead of writing equation of motion. Okay, we need to solve that because it is in the differential equation, double differential equation. Okay, when you solve that, then finally you will get a curve. Okay, harmonic curve. So here in this third stage, we will find the solution for this equation of motion. Okay, so here while solving these, you know, we will see different cases. First, we will see the system which are not having the damping, and after that we will see the system which are having the damping. Okay, when you have the damping, then there are some other concepts come. Okay, critical damp and how that damping will affect the, you know, vibration. Can you damp, over damp, or can you under damp? Okay, so different concepts we are seeing. And here in this case, the logarithmic decrement concept is again important. Okay, in the examination, the main concentration of the examiner is in the, you know, the equation of motion. And here with the damping, if you consider with damping, then in that damping, with damping, you know, they may ask you to find out what is the damping ratio, what is the logarithmic decrement. Okay, if logarithmic decrement is given, then how to find out the damping ratio or the damping coefficient of damping. So they, you know, same formula they will ask in different ways. Okay, so the concentration of your concentration should be, you know, should be here and as well as here. Okay, and after that, you know, we will consider the forced vibration systems. Okay, and then after that we will consider some of the unbalanced vibration system. Okay, in the previous chapter when we studied the balancing, why we studied the balancing? Okay, if you don't balance the system, especially which are having the rotating or the reciprocating masses, then what happens? That unbalanced force is you know, directly proportional to the omega square. That means at a higher speeds, you know, because of this unbalanced force, it will produce some shaking effect on the, you know, engine frame. Because of that, what happened? It will subjected to a lot of vibrations. Okay, so those vibrations are formed because of the unbalanced forces. Okay, we will see here in the same thing the vibrations because of the unbalanced forces also. Okay, unbalanced forces. Okay, and here only we will see, you know, the vibration system where the fixed support also moving along with the, you know, elements of the system. Elements of the system means spring, dash part, and then mass. Those are called as the elements. Okay, and after the, and see, there are very less number of questions that are coming from this fourth concept. Okay, and after that we will see the vibration of a rotating shaft. Rotating shaft, you know, it is having the eccentricity. Okay, so here this problem is important. Okay, again, this concept is important because many questions directly come. This concept is very simple. Okay, so only one formula, simple formula you need to remember. That apart from the formula, the concept also you need to understand. Okay, so here this is important, and then here this is important, and this is also important. But anyway, everything is interrelated, and once if you understand how to form the equation of motion, then everything is a cakewalk. Okay, everything else is a simple mathematics. Only thing here is this forming the equation of motion is a tricky part here. Okay, so here we will take different cases like transverse vibration, longitudinal vibration, with force, without force, with damping, without damping. Okay, different cases we will take.